Good evening. I'm Ayla Peterson, and I teach here in the music department at the King's University. I'd like to welcome you all to Ashley's recital this evening. Ashley is not a music major, but under the capable instruction of Beth Levia, she has made a great contribution to the musical life of King's over these past few years. I'm really looking forward to hearing this recital and looking forward to playing in some of it. So join me in welcoming Ashley to the stage.
Thank you everybody for coming. I'm Ashley and this is Katie. And the first piece we'll be playing is a Baroque piece. It's by Marcello. It's Marcello's concerto in D minor for oboe. This piece is Baroque and it's originally written by Marcello without any of the decorations or anything in it. And then Bach took his hand to it and decided to put in all of these ornaments. So in the second movement you'll hear all of these kinds of things that Bach put in.
Thank you.
This next piece is a little bit, written a little bit after the previous one. This is a romantic piece by Robert Schumann. It's actually really three pieces, three romances written by him. It was supposedly written as a Christmas present for his wife, Clara Schumann, but that could be debated because she was also a very accomplished musician and composer.
Thank you.
we have one more piece before we go to intermission. This piece is by Maurice Ravel. It's called Pièce en forme de habanera. It's inspired after the dance, which is named after the pepper. And supposedly, the dance is just as hot as the pepper is.
Thank you.
Okay, so we'll start this next half by playing something a little bit different. This piece is by Lutoslawski. It's called Epitaph. So if you didn't know, an epitaph is the words on the gravestone. And this piece is written in memory of the composer Alan Richardson. And it's really interesting because Alan Richardson, none of his music is really played anymore. But this piece by a different composer is what remains in his legacy.
Thank you.
waiting, I'd like to thank everyone for being here. My grandparents are here from Lethbridge. Regan's grandparents are here all the way from Manitoba to watch her play with us in this next piece. So thank you everyone for being here. This next piece is by Françaix, and it is called The Flower Clock. And so I think we've got a couple people in here who are in biology. Can someone tell me who the father of botany was? Linnaeus. So Linnaeus was a botanist, the father of botany, and he came up with this idea of the flower clock. And so he wanted to plant a garden where all the different flowers in the garden bloom at different times of day. So you could tell what time it was just by looking at what flowers were blooming. And Françaix heard this, and he thought that would be a great idea to write a piece. Unfortunately, Françaix was not much of a botanist, and I was really disappointed to learn that these flowers don't actually bloom at these times of day. But I think it's a really neat idea.
Thank you.